Code comments. Hey everybody, my name is Burke Holland, and in this video, we're going to take a look at code comments in JavaScript. Code comments are lines in your JavaScript code that the JavaScript runtime just ignores. Now, you might want to do this for several reasons. Could be to leave a handy tip in the code that explains and gives some context. Could be to make a reminder for yourself when you're developing for something you need to come back and complete later. Or it could be to just take an active line or block of lines of code and comment them out during development so that they don't actually execute, but you're not deleting them from the file. Now, when it comes to comments in JavaScript, there are two types. There's single line comments and multi-line comments. Single line comments are indicated by two slashes at the beginning of a line. Now, usually the editor that you're using will gray these lines out or change their color so that you know that they're commented out. Single line comments only apply to the current line, so any code on subsequent lines still executes and is not commented out. Multiline comments are designed to comment out multiple lines without having to put those slashes at the beginning of every line. Multiline comments start with a slash and then a star, and they end in reverse with a star and then a slash. You can think of multiline comments as starting with a slash and ending with a slash. And everything that's in between that is commented out, no matter how many lines it takes up. Now, in the real world, most editors have a keyboard shortcut just for commenting lines out and then removing the comments. For VS Code, that's Command for Mac or Control for Windows and the L key. And this just toggles comments on and off for a line. And normally, instead of using multi-line comments, you'll just highlight a block of code and then use Command or Control L to toggle the comments on or toggle them off. And so you don't use multi-line comments as much as you think that you might in code because the editor handles the single line comments. So we don't really care how many double slashes there are since we're not manually putting them in or taking them out. Now, it's as important to talk about when you should use comments as it is about what comments are. When you first start programming, you're going to feel like you need to comment everything and say what everything does. I did this. I had comments on all of my code. That's actually unnecessary and ironically makes your code harder to read. If your code can't be understood by someone who knows JavaScript, then instead of a comment, what you might need is to refactor the code to make it simpler and easier to understand. Now, oftentimes what this means is taking a chunk of code that has a comment that explains what it does and wrapping it in a function that has a name that describes what the code does. So for instance, we might have a block of code that reverses a string and a comment that lets the reader know this code reverses a string. A better solution would be to take that code, put it in a function called reverse string, and now the code is self-documenting. We don't need a comment here. The person reading the code can look at it and discern from the function name, oh, this code reverses a string. In summary, there are two types of comments in JavaScript. There are single line comments that use two slashes and only apply to the current line. There are multi-line comments that start with a slash and a star and end with a star and a slash, and everything in between that is commented out no matter how many lines you use. And lastly, remember, take it easy on comments. You probably don't need as many as you think you do. Use them judiciously. See if you can make your code self-documenting instead.